सी प्रोग्राम टू काउंट फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ईच एलिमेंट इन एन एरे. सो हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ प्रोग्राम आउट ऑफ दिस. द प्रोग्राम विल बी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू नो द साइज ऑफ द एरे. देन वेंस द नंबर्स आर बींग एंटर्ड इन द एरे, हाउ मेनी टाइम्स अ नंबर इज रिपीटेड, दैट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 1, 1, 1. So 1 is 3 times. So 1 is 3 times. So 3 is the frequency of 1. This is what we have to print. That is, once this program is executed or run, and these are the numbers being entered, you need to be showing the user that number of 1s is 3. Number of 2s, 2, 2. So number of 2s are 2, like this. So this is what you have to do. Now this is the program. First of all, if you are doing it in C, so hash include stdio.h, conio.h, int main, this is the program. And for, if you are doing it C++, just make it as stdio, not stdio, but iostream.h. First thing will be, enter the size of the array. Now just assume that the size of the array user entered is, say, 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So user wanted to enter 10 numbers. So enter the size of the array, n will be 10. So we have initialized n as an integer, or not declared. Now enter the elements in the array. For that we need a loop. So we have a for loop here. From I equal to 0, I also we have declared here. I equal to 0 till the n, that is I less than n. It will not go up to n. It has to be less than n because it is an array. Array subscript always start with a 0. So I less than n, you scan up the numbers and you put it in this array AI. So we have also defined an array here, A. So this is the array which will be taking the number. So just assume that user has entered these numbers. So let me write this number. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, 4, and then 3, 2, 1, 1, 4. These are the number being entered by the user. Now this loop, we start from I equal to 0, I less than n. This is the first loop. Inside this, we have another for loop. So there are two loops here with a if check also. Two if checks. So what all these are doing? First of all, we will start with I equal to 0. That is, this I is the first one, first value. And we'll go up to n. But this will only be coming, you can say the pointer will come here only when this internal loop is finished. So what this internal loop is doing? First of all, we have a counter here, C equal to 0. We have initialized C equal to 1. Now we start with 1. So one time 1 has come, the frequency is 1 because 1 has come. So that is why we initialize it to be 1. Now if AI not equal to minus 1, I'll just come back to this one. What is this? But before that, let me say you for J equal to I plus 1, J less than N, J plus plus. What this J is doing? I is a counter starting from here, or the variable starting from here. Now J has to be the next one. I don't want to check 1 with 1. I want to check with the other number. So this is the counter J, or this is the variable J. Now this J is increasing. So J has to start with I plus 1. J has to be the next number which has to be checked from the previous number in the array. And this also goes to N. So now 1 will be checked with 2. J will increment now because this internal loop will finish first. So J will come here now. Then it will go up to this point till all the numbers are being checked. So inside this, if AI equal to AJ, so if this number is meeting any of the J which is 1, so this 1 is meeting with 1. So first time this will be checked 1 and 2, this will not meet. 1 and 3 not will meet. So it will go up to this point and 1 and 1 will meet. So 1 and 1 are equal. So when these are equal, we will increment the counter. So we have countered already initialized to 1 because 1 was already there. Now one more 1 is been encountered. So 1 and 1 are equal. So this and this are equal. So we increase the counter. Then in this point, we put a minus 1. Now we just vanish, or we don't want any one to be here because this one has already been checked. So now we forcefully put a minus 1 here. So this minus 1 has been put at this place. When we come out this loop next time, this will run and again J will go here because this has to complete till n. So it has not been completed. We have pushed minus 1. It will, j will increment. Now 1 will again be found. Means this 1 and that 1 will match. So again the counter has to be increased. So previously counter was 1. One time 1 has come, so the counter will be 2. Now 1 again is being encountered, so the counter will become 3. And again at this point we will put a minus 1. Now we come out, because we have reached here, 4 will not which match with 1. So we have reached here and j has reached here. So we have 1, 2, 3. So the counter number will be 3. So number of times 1 has come is 3. Now we come out of this for loop internal. And now we put this C in this BI. What is this BI? BI is another array. This BI is the array to keep the numbers which we have got, the frequency we have got. So BI equal to C. Now I was initially 0. So this is 0. And how much we have to put? This 3. So 3 will be put here. So number of time once has come is 3. Now I has to be increased. I is now here. Now I is here. And now J will start from I plus 1. Now J will start from here. So this is fixed. Now all J will be incremented and all these values are checked with 2. Till the time this 2 is received. Now this 2 is encountered. When these 2 and 2 are equal, we started with 2, so we have to have a counter as 1. But here 2 and 2 are meeting, so they are equal. So now counter will be increased by 1. Because they are equal, so counter will be increased by 1. And in this place, because this has already been checked, we have to forcefully put minus 1. So now this will also be minus 1. Again, this will go up. And finally, it will reach here because there is no other 2. So counter is already, this was 1. And now one more time this 2 has been found. So counter is 2. So this counter will be put in this another array. So 2 is here. So I hope you got the idea. This will go up and number of times. So this 3 will be checked. 3, 3. So 2 will come here. And this will be minus 1. Now 4 will be checked. So 4, this will be minus 1. And this will be minus 1. And 4 will, this will come as 3. So this is array A. And those which values are being checked and they are repeated, we put forcefully minus 1. And here we have, in the another array, we have put the frequencies. Now we need a for loop from I 0 to N. If AI not equal to minus 1, why we are checking this? Because we only want this number to be printed at this AI. Not these numbers, because this is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So we don't want these numbers now. So this one, 1 will be printed here. So if AI is not equal to 1, 1 will be printed here. That is here. And corresponding to this BI will be printed. That is the corresponding number from here. So number of 1 is 3. Number of 1 is 3. Next time it will go up. And again, number of 2 is 2, and number of 3 is 2, and number of 4 is 3. This is how it will be printed. This is the program to find the frequency of the numbers which are in the array.